Hi, my name is Johnny Vaught, and this is The Review, where we discuss the latest and the greatest movies. With each movie, I'll be using one of three ways to review them. I will either suggest that you go and see it, meaning that I think that this movie is worth the money. Get out there, go to the theater, see it on the big screen, and have the full experience. Screen it, by which I mean, you can probably wait. You can give it its time, let it have its theatrical run, and when it is ready to come to you, you can go to it and see it at home, screen it. Or I'll be advising you to skip it. I don't think that it's worth the effort. Hear about what your friends say, make your opinion based on that, but I would suggest that you skip it. This week, we will be discussing The Black Panther, which is the latest addition to the Marvel Cinematic Universe. It is the first since Thor Ragnarok, and the last until the Avengers Infinity War, where everything that we have been working towards is coming together. This is the 18th addition to the Marvel Cinematic Universe, and my favorite so far. Like I said, I'm going to tell you either to see it, screen it, or skip it. And with The Black Panther, I am fully suggesting that you go and see it. It is a big movie, and you are going to want to see it in the largest screen that you possibly can. There is some great, big, wide-open scenes that are best seen as big as possible. Some quick facts about Black Panther before we get into the specifics of the movie. It came out on February 16th after being announced back in October of 2014. The Black Panther runs for 2 hours and about 15 minutes, and it is a fast 2 hours and 15 minutes. I wanted more. At the beginning, it gets going right away. You have about a quick 6-minute scene, and then you see the opening credits, and I was in it from the first moment. You do want to stay till the very end of the movie. There are two post-credit scenes. They're good. They're good. You want to see them, definitely. Things about the movie that are you're going to want to know going in, it is set in the fictional country of Wakanda. It is part of the Marvel Universe that we have not gotten to see yet in the MCU. It is a futuristic society that is also isolated from the world intentionally. You need to see it to believe it. It's super cool. At one point, they fly into it. It's covered up by these trees. All of a sudden, you're seeing it, and it's like a whole new world. Very highly recommend that you go and see this movie. I loved it. The hair and the costumes in this movie are super cool. A lot of the press about the movie is about how this movie doesn't look like other movies. It looks very different. I'd say the best look in the movie is the first shot that you get of the main antagonist. He is dressed super modern. He looks absolutely as cool as can possibly be. And he has the best hair in the movie. I am a professional hairstylist, and occasionally I get distracted when I'm seeing a movie just looking at the hair. And Eric Killmonger has the coolest hair you've seen in a movie in a bit. I promise you're going to be seeing people influenced by his styles coming forward for the rest of the year. Other things to consider in this movie, it has some very, very strong female characters throughout. The best character in the movie, as far as I'm concerned, is the main character's sister, Shuri. She is like Q from the 007 series, but way better, super cool. And you at one point go and see her lab, which is very similar to like the part of a James Bond movie where you'd go see the Q lab. And it's just the future. It's the future. It looks super cool. Other things that stuck with me about this movie, without giving away too many spoilers here on the review, I will always do my best to avoid any major spoilers. At one point, there is a rhinoceros wearing armor. You gotta see it to believe it. Go and see it. At one point in the movie, the main villain looks at something, is questioned about it, and his response to it is, "I'm feeling it." Which just like sums up how I feel about this movie. Like, I'm feeling it. Like, it is so cool. The entire crowd was so lively when we saw it. Everyone was like right there in it. It was just like a buzz to it. Like, this movie feels different than other movies. It's much more fun than other movies can be sometimes. And I can't recommend it enough. The number one character that I keep finding myself thinking about is named M'Baku. He is played by Winston Duke, who had no previous film experience before, and he does an excellent job. There's one scene that when you've seen the movie, you'll know what I'm talking about. You can't stop thinking about it. M'Baku steals the show next to Shuri, Letitia Wright. Great job. And then I really hope I've conveyed as best that I can that this movie is one not to miss. You want to go see it. Next time, when you join us on the review, I will be discussing A Wrinkle in Time, the winner of the Best Picture from the Oscar race, and Wes Anderson's upcoming stop-motion animation movie, The Isle of Dogs. If you want to come back and join us then, we'd love to have you. Thanks.